At the Blick Summer Series of Workshops at the NAEA Studios in Alexandria, Virginia, we worked with a group of art educators on an arpillera project. We explored the story behind the arpilleras, and then the teachers created their own versions. They discovered that it's way more than a felt picture. The story behind the Chilean arpilleras is both heartbreaking and empowering. For 17 years, starting in 1973, Chile was ruled by military dictatorship. Many people fled the country, many were imprisoned, and many people just disappeared. In Santiago, groups of women who were missing husbands or sons gathered to take part in communal sewing groups. Sewing, being a women's craft, was not questioned by the authorities. These groups formed with the purpose of emotional support, but also for creating a sellable product to ease their poverty. But they quickly developed into a way to quietly protest and express their own experiences through art. Now, there's a long history of this type of tapestry making in Central and South America, so this really wasn't a new art form. Up until the 1970s, arpilleras were most often created with religious or historical scenes that appealed to tourists and patrons. In contrast, the arpilleras that were created in Santiago showed scenes of violence, hardship, and heartbreak. They were smuggled out of the country by human rights activists, and the world became aware of the situation. Where newspapers and television at that time were heavily censored, art was able to tell the true story. And with scraps and stitches came change. Now, the word arpillera refers to burlap or sackcloth. On a rough surface such as this, story pictures were assembled, usually by multiple artists working on sections at a time. I have a contemporary example of an arpillera from Peru to show you. Now, the background is usually very flat, and it sets the scene for the arpillera as being urban or rural. Fabric scraps create houses and plants and mountains. In the meantime, another artist might be working on the figures. Now, because these are the most important part of the arpillera, they're often stuffed like little dolls, so they stand out. Sometimes needle felting, woven reed, or found objects are used, such as this little match right here. These can be very dimensional. At the workshop, I offered the art educators a choice of themes for their arpilleras. Now, the first theme was no theme. Given a chance to make artwork for 90 minutes, teachers followed their own creative instincts with the materials provided. The second theme was to follow the lead of the arpilleras and show us what was going on in their portion of the world, good or bad. Some teachers use this opportunity to tell the story of a trip, an anniversary celebration, or a child's journey. The third option was to recognize the power of the arpillera for lifting up hope. In this world today, there are so many issues and problems for an artist to speak to advocate for, or to protest against. In my examples, a community garden replaces an empty city lot. This piece speaks about alternative energy sources, wind and water. A teacher pictured her school with landscaping and a sculpture garden. An arpillera can express big dreams. So, using a piece of ordinary burlap as a background, a story picture can be created with felt, fabric scraps, yarn, embroidery. But I'd like to show you a new item today. This is called simply and accurately fluff. Now, fluff mimics wool, but it's completely synthetic. No allergies, no animal products, and it's also very affordable. If you've ever done needle felting, you probably know that the needles are quite sharp. I have an example of one right here. They have tiny little notches along the sides that catch the barbs of the wool and work them together. I'd like to introduce you to a new technique today that will allow elementary age students to enjoy the felting process quite safely. Instead of a needle, this technique uses a non-skid paper clip, which also has notches on the side. Once you open the paper clip to make a tool, take a small piece of burlap and place it over a block of styrofoam, or you could use a sponge. Select a color of fluff. Fluff could be cut apart with scissors, or you can simply pull it apart into smaller pieces. Place it over the burlap and stab it down through the holes into the styrofoam. The notches on the paper clip force it through the holes to the other side, and the styrofoam holds it in place. Now you can spread the fluff out and just keep pushing it through very flat. You can twist it, you could braid it, you could knot it, you could optically mix colors by felting small amounts of 2 to 3 colors together. on your arpillera, this might be a good way to create some botanical items such as flowers, leaves, or grass. It could be used for hair, fur, or clouds. When finished faux felting, gently pull the piece away from the styrofoam. And you can see on the back side how the fluff has come through. Now, in order for this to not come back out again, take a piece of felt and just glue that over the backside when you're done. That will keep it from loosening or from fraying. Once your arpillera is finished, you can glue a dowel rod or a strip of balsa wood to the top to create a hanger. Now, you can find fluff and all of these materials at dickblick.com. Why don't we watch the art educators as they create their own arpilleras? So, I gave you guys three options of themes to follow. What if you choose? I see that looks like we've got a wedding scene happening over here.
It's the story of my marriage. I thought
oh, it's you know,
your
wedding.
And family, you were talking a lot about history and family.
Yes.
So, my husband and I met because of a fire. We both do charity work, and so we met because of a fire, so I had the fire there. Then we got married, and now we're in easy chairs, and we're old.
Recently reconnected with my Mexican heritage, and I had a really close group of friends just get married. So this is kind of just, you know, familiarizing myself with some of the symbols.
Wonderful.